Hey everybody, welcome back. Here we are, we're back in the drum room. We're up and running officially now. I'm excited, Eric is excited, everybody's excited. So we're sitting around thinking, what's the first lesson we wanna shoot out here? Well, we went through, we set everything up, talked through getting some angles, talked through tuning, that sort of thing. So I thought, you know what, it's real important, even if you're just beginning, just picking up the sticks, just getting into the drum set, we wanna talk about dynamics. Some of this stuff may be a little hard to get a hold of in the beginning, but just put it in the back of your mind, and you more seasoned guys, just sort of revisit this stuff and check this out. Now, as drummers, we spend the majority of our time hand-wise, we're going to discuss hands here, dynamic-wise first, we'll get to the kick later, on three main sources, our snare drum, hi-hat, and the ride, where we keep our time. So we're going to look at those first. First, we'll look at the snare drum. Now, dynamically, there is a technique called the rim shot, very, very important. And what that is you're going to strike the rim of the drum and the head at the same time to create a nice crack, a fat backbeat, and it sounds like this. Okay, now, you can hear how that sounds really abrasive and it brings out a lot of crack, a lot of body out of the snare. You want that so you can have a dynamic level up here, and then the ghost notes can be down here and you can get a lot of cool dynamic range out of your snare drum. Now, finding that sweet spot where you can hit that snare drum rim shot with the right and left hand can be a little tricky. Sometimes you might find yourself hitting the rim only. It'll sound like this. Or sometimes you might be a little the other way and you might just end up hitting the head only, which would sound like this. So like I said, don't freak out. It's no big deal. You're going to find your sweet spot. A couple of things to pay attention to. Obviously, the height and the angle of the snare drum. Concentrate on that first, especially if your seat height feels comfortable. But realize that you can lower or raise your seat slightly. So if your leg gets in the way of your right rim shot or vice versa, whatever, you can get it. So again, just be patient. Remember, you'll find it very, very important. We're going to be doing a lot of ghost notes and a lot of rim shots. So work hard on that. The second thing I'd like to talk about is the hi-hat. Now, a lot of things are going on here with these two cymbals, but we're going to concentrate on, again, how we can get dynamics with our stick. It's a lot like, I view it a lot like the snare drum in that you have the shoulder of the stick hitting into the side or the flat of the hi-hat to create sort of a chunky, thick sound. Sounds like this. Or you can take the tip of the stick and go toward the center and get a much lighter sound like this. So I sort of view that as, you know, the thick part of the shoulder of the stick is almost like the rim shot, and then the tip is the lighter ghost note. So you're going to get those dynamics out of this as well. Another thing to really consider right away, maybe tricky, your left foot, the amount of pressure that you're applying on these two cymbals as you put them together is going to have a great deal to do with how it feels as well and the dynamics. I'll give you a quick demo of that. The third is going to be the ride. The ride, just like the hi-hat, has the same thing going on for our, quote, rim shot or aggressive sound. We're back to the shoulder of the stick, and the bell part of the cymbal sounds like this. And then you have the tip of the stick and the flat of the cymbal. You hear a lot in jazz and swing, or when you're playing like straight ace or certain groove, sounds like this. And then again, just like the hi-hat, you could put them both together and do combinations where you're playing the bell and the flat of the cymbal. All right, there you go, dynamics. Now again, we're just dealing with the hands only. Bass drum and the feet are going to come in later. But for now, we're going to work on getting a dynamic range from our snare drum involving rim shots, ghost notes. Remember the shoulder of the stick, the tip of the stick, pressure with the left foot, really big. Ride, you got the bell, and then the flat. Okay, so I'll give you a quick demo of what these sound like, and be sure and check back for more.